In an interview with NPR recently, former Ohio Republican Governor John Kasich said that he was shocked that Republicans are allowing Donald Trump to just, destroy America by refusing to concede. He's shocked. Here's his exact quote. He said, "Biden clearly won this election, and it's just sort of amazing to me that Republicans just keep sitting on their hands. It makes no sense." Huh. It makes no sense that America's Republican Party would sit there and do nothing as one of their own clings to power that he knows he doesn't have anymore. Huh. Who could have thought that? Who could have thought that the party that twisted legal definitions and stretched the law to justify their own torture methods in Iraq, who would have thought that this party would have done this? Who would have thought that the party that spent 8 years obstructing every single good thing Obama tried to do would turn around and do this? Who would have thought that the party that spent 8 years trying to impeach Bill Clinton and finally got him for lying about oral sex, who would have thought that they would have done this? Who would have thought that the party that spent the 1980s lying to us about how the economy works while also simultaneously killing unions, thus destroying the middle class in America, who would have thought they would be capable of this? Who would have thought that the former governor of Ohio, who signed one of the most restrictive abortion bills into law, and also destroyed unions, and also helped suppress the vote in his state, who would have thought he would have been shocked by what the Republican Party is doing today? The only thing shocking about this is the fact that the Huffington Post ran with the headline that said, "John Kasich stunned GOP isn't defending democracy against Trump." This is why the Huffington Post is trash now. That was their headline. How can you write an article like this? How can you pretend that John Kasich is a friend of the Democratic Party without calling out his horrid history and acting like the GOP hasn't always been horrible? For real, I know the Democratic Party's not great. Trust me, we go after him all the time. But to sit there and pretend that the Republican Party hasn't been horrible for the lifetimes of most people in this country at this point, I'm not 40. For my entire life, the Republican Party's been pretty bad. Pretty much, if you were born in the Nixon era or after, the Republican Party has been trash for at least your entire lifetime. They have been corrupt. They have been incompetent. And they have been dangerous liars. That's the Republican Party that we've grown up with. That's what you've been for our entire lifetime. And we shouldn't expect anything different from you. In fact, we don't. I don't expect anything different from John Kasich. What John Kasich is doing right now is trying to separate himself from the pack. He is trying to go out there and say, "Listen, I'm not like them. I'm one of the good ones. Trust me. Vote for me. Forget about all those horrible things I did in Ohio, because, you know, that puts me literally on the same level of all as all these other Republicans. But, you know, forget all that, and I'll see you in 2024. That's the real message John Kasich was sending in this interview, and it's pathetic that Huffington Post didn't pick up on that. One of today's video sponsors is Privacy, and right now, they have a wonderful offer for all of our Ring of Fire viewers. Go to privacy.com/ROF, sign up for your privacy account, and you will receive $5. Privacy.com, their service is absolutely one of the most vital in an online world today, especially during the pandemic. Everyone is encouraged to stay home, so we're ordering more things online. And so your bank account information is more vulnerable than ever. Privacy gives you security. This is a product that I use all of the time, and here's why. If you have ever had your bank account information stolen, if it's been part of a data leak, that is a massive headache trying to get your money back, trying to repair your credit. Privacy helps take away some of that concern. What Privacy does is it provides a browser extension, or you can go right into the website or into the app, and it can create a virtual bank account or credit card number. It could be a temporary number that only is used one time, or it can be merchant specific, meaning you can create a bank account card that only works for one particular website. So if that account happens to get hacked or has a massive data breach, that card number no longer works with any other website. That is how privacy helps protect your bank account information in an increasingly insecure online world. So again, go to privacy.com/ROF. You get $5 free just for signing up. Or if you don't want to type it in, just click the link at the top of the video description below.